Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. Jet Scale Models is going to be bringing you part 6 of this MENG Merkava Mark IVM with the trophy self-defense mechanism. And today we're going to start getting into some weathering. But first, what we're going to do is paint the Pioneer tools. And we're going to be using an acrylic paint. I believe it might be an AK or Vallejo type of paint. I just mixed up a gray using a white and a black. So my goal today with this video is to introduce some of the weathering techniques that I want to use on this kit. This is all sort of like a work in progress kind of thing. I don't have any laid out formula for every one of my models. I have to approach each kit and each situation individually. And my thinking process usually is all over the map sometimes, but I usually have a starting point and I build up layers and I work towards trying to make it look as authentic as possible by looking at references. And a lot of it also, though, is what they call happy accidents.
We just have to sort of make a decision where we want the little stream to come from, maybe back in here. And I know this is going to look like we're destroying everything. Don't worry about it. We don't make mistakes. We have happy accidents.
Okay, let's take a look at the clear parts. So I'm going to pre-tape them or mask them. And then I'm going to paint the back silver. And then I guess I'll put them in place. And then after that, I'll add some of that hologrammic style film. We'll be right back. Okay, well, that went pretty good. Everything has been protected with the masking tape that I need to get protected. I'll be placing these into their locations on the hull and the turret, and at that point, I'll come back with the base color and blend them into the situation. And then once that's all done, I can come back and remove this masking to reveal the clear plastic in its pristine state. But first, we're going to jump into painting the jerry can a nice black color. So next up, what we'll do is we'll paint the back of these periscope parts with a silver color. So now we gotta put these driver's periscopes in place. Let's put these periscopes onto this turret here. All right, now I'm gonna go paint the body color on here. I probably could have done this in an earlier part of the thing, but not knowing this kit, I took the safe way. But yeah, now it's got a silver backing and I'll go spray it the body color. All right, next up we'll take the masking off the side shields and see how everything looks.
So you can see I've done a little bit of sort of like vertical lines with my airbrush just to break it up a bit. I sort of like did a lighter version on the top of the base coat.
When I was looking at reference photographs for this Merkava tank, I noticed that the center of the wheels have a little bit of a red highlight, so that's what I'm going to be doing here. Here I'm trying to portray some polished metal for the machine gun placement area This is like a little sliding area where the machine gun is mounted. So I'm using the Humbrol gunmetal again, and it really polishes up beautifully to give a sort of realistic metallic sheen. Basically, I put it on, and then I come back and I buff it up. The idler wheels will be getting the same treatment where they come in contact with the track. All right, let's do a little test fit and see how this all looks. So I'm using future and a little bit of water, and I'm trying to do some pin washing that way. Magic wash is something that the aircraft modelers often use for things like where the landing gear bays are. It's just a really easy way to add some detail with things sort of like being pulled out to show more detail. And I thought I would try it on this project here, but in the end I just ended up using some oil paint.
Put a little water down. So I like it, but it kind of leaves tide marks, doesn't it? Over here. I don't like that. The reason I'm trying this is because when I use oil paint sometimes, it just, with this sort of flat paint finish, it grabs a hold inside of the paint because it's so porous. It's not sealed like a semi-gloss or a gloss coat. But I don't know, maybe I can try some oil paint now.
Yeah, I like the oil because I can take it off better and it doesn't Thank you.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Now that all the pin washing and washes have been done, I'm going to introduce some dry brushing. This is an older technique, but it works still pretty good. What I'm trying to do here is try and highlight some of the details by hitting just the top part of.
Thank you.
Now that we've finished doing the dry brushing on the turret and the hull, we can pay some attention to the side shielding. So first of all, we'll have to go in with the wash and we're going to wipe away any of the excess. After that, we'll come back in with the dry brushing and pick out the highlights. Thank you. All right, gang, at this point, we'll come back in with some of the dry brushing effect. All right, this has been a really long one, and I hope some of you have stayed till the end. I just wanted to cover everything that I did so that anybody new to any of this would understand the process rather than just doing really short little clips and maybe speeding things up. Because often when I watch YouTube channels where they have things speeded up, you don't really understand what is exactly going on there. So that's why I've chosen in this video to include a lot of it that maybe might be a bit boring for some of you, but in the end, I'm happy with what's going on. Having said that, at this point, we are sort of at the first level of aging on this kit. Next episode, I'll be getting into pigments. I'll be taking care of the tracks, and that was a pretty involved process after all. And I'm not your typical model builder, I guess. I have a little bit of, I don't know what it is, but I get kind of going down rabbit holes and really doing a lot more things than most people probably do. But hey, it's about having fun, and sometimes I have fun trying to figure out, you know, really detailed ways of doing some aging. In any case, I think we'll wrap it up there. I hope you enjoyed this channel's offering today, and I guess we'll see you next time. In the meantime and in between time, that's another edition of Jet Scale Models. Y'all come back now, you hear?
Play. Oh no, oh no. He just ran straight into the barriers and the conflict.
Oh my goodness. Oh,
and that is car number 93.